I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports.
All right.
Turnovers will be a focus in today's game. The Broncos are number one in turnover differential, and they'll be up against the Raiders team that knows they have to take care of the ball. With that, let's go out to Sports Authority Field at Mile High. Here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, we are a couple miles west of the Colorado State Capitol building as we come to you from Sports Authority Field at Mile High here in downtown Denver. Today, it's a match.
Didn't want to take that out.
West between the Oakland Raiders and the Denver Broncos. One receiver to the left is Cooper. Carnell on first down. Looking left side, he's got it complete. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine. And Mr. Cooper, Amari, a headliner in this offensive unit.
Brandon, it's rare that you get guys so polished coming out of college. But Amari Cooper has carried himself like a pro probably since he was 6 years old. He is a terrific talent.
Looking right. And he'll find some space up to about the 25.
Weak sauce move.
Five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now. And a look now at how the Broncos line up defensively.
Vontae Davis is one of the strongest cornerbacks in the league. Equally adept at playing the run and the pass.
Third play here. This opening drive is they're up against a third and five. From the gun, it's Carr. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Amari Cooper, his intended receiver. And fourth down coming up.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
He'll send this one into the Mile High air, and it's a good one. And a good result there as that'll get out of bounds and pin them back at their 10-yard line. They go play action here on first down. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Again on second and 10, it's Lynch. Got a man and he hits him in stride. 6 yards is the pickup and that'll lead to a third down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Completed pass on second down. Now it's third down as the defense looks for the stop.
Here we go now. Blue lining. Blue lining.
From the gun on third down, it's Lynch. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, fourth and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to
the Come on!
Without a doubt, they're the ones that typically end up in the end zone. Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Carr again here on 2nd and 10. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought down after a good game. A big play that time on the catch and run. And the Raiders are going to get a new set of downs. Midfield. Here's Carr. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. Their big tight end. His first touchdown on the year. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. On is the Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3 and out.
And now to have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. Lynch to throw over the middle, and it's incomplete. Time to meet the defensive starters for the Oakland Raiders, and you want to discuss one of their safeties.
I certainly do. Carl Joseph out of West Virginia always did a great job policing the middle of the field. A big hitter, knocked the ball away, but really added to his game as last year as a Mountaineer. Became a better cover guy and a better ball hawk before he got injured. They're really going to love him in Oakland.
Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. And he'll get it up the middle. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball. Receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I will hear about that from him soon.
play fake here on first down. Going for Hilton, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. The Raiders' offense now, they trot back out, and they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Here's Carr to throw. Looking deep downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target. And it's second down.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
Second down following the incompletion. For Cooper again. This time he finds it. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
An expecting pass. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Being chased out left. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. Charles, that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him two touchdowns here early.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on fourth down, that's big for the defense.
And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
To the air here after the INT, and he will find his man on the outside. Give him nine there on the first down completion. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver. We asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
They'll come out in the pistol on second down. Rawls. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. He lost two there. And it's third down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Two yards to go here on third down. Lynch now throwing on third. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
They were full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab.
Right, here we go. Green 39.
They'll send the tight end in motion left. First down, this is Rawls. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
So what will they do? On the ground, through the air? Let's see. 2nd and 9. They come out here in the eye. To throw on 2nd. Wide open receiver complete. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff.
When we talked about him.
They like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Now the offense lining up 1st and 10. Again, we'll see the pistol here. They go play action here on 1st down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Back alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Bronco football to begin quarter number 2, but they face a 2nd and long to start things out. In motion goes the tight end. On 2nd down, Lynch. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. And now the passing game here in the 2nd quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football. But you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Now Lynch to throw. And he can hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And McManus able to put it through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So this offensive unit, they've now had 3 drives, and they only have 3 points to show for it.
Payoff is the key for everything. How many offenses have we talked to that say we have to finish drives? Thus far, this team hasn't finished it quite the way they wanted to.
And now Oakland ready to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time? Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And a nice gain of 21 yards. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
And he did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school. On 1st and 10, here's Carr. This one caught left side by Cooper. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose
What? Like, how much shit is that a thing?
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye.
That's silly.
They come out here in the eye. Now Carr throwing on second down. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Von Miller in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year. So it's third and long, and defensively not a real surprise there in the dime. From the gun, it's Carr. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And there's touchdown, Raiders! Amari Cooper, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders add on to their lead. The fly route works for the TD grab.
And you know what the receivers love to say? If we get even with the defender, we're leaving. And that's exactly what he did, all the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end catching it once he got over the stripe.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. So the Broncos coming out now. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Drops it underneath for Rawls. Call it a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll make it second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Second down now after the pass completion. On second down, here's Lynch. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They go play action here on first down. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Well, we guys making plays this game.
The speed and the hands, a great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Throwing here, Lynch on first down. Caught left side by Hilton. And all the way home for a Bronco score. T.Y. Hilton, his first touchdown on the year. And the Broncos have cut it to within a score.
The catch and the touchdown, they were the end result of
it. And oh, it's blocked. after the touchdown. Here's McManus now to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Able to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Carr again here on second and 10. Finding time. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Gerald McCoy busting through to get him for a loss of six. So the D-line's going to spread out. Cooper, the man in motion right. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. On third and long, it's Carr. He's got time. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. The Bronco offense now set to come back out onto the field, and they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive, but they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together, but they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
On first down, it's Lynch. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. They try the corner route there, Charles, and it works to perfection.
Boy, that's hard on a defensive back because if you get any faker move to the inside, you have to respect it, and then the receiver breaks back to the sideline.
And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
Time to step aside. Back to Denver right after this. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Hilton, the lone receiver right.
Here we go now.
Now Lynch on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
Here we go now.
On second down, Lynch out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Right, right, right. Three down, three down. Hurry up, here we go.
They'll run the option left, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11.
All right, here we go.
Lynch looking to throw on second. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Now whistles and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They got to get to the 23 here on third.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun! Here we go! Green, 39! Green, 39!
On third down, Lynch. And oh, he's going to be hit and driven into the turf. Now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here's Riley Dixon now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
First and 10, here's Carr. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And he's got his man on the out route. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Wide open, Amari Cooper. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield across the 45. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. On first down, Carr. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Carr to throw again. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together.
All right, here we go.
Now they'll bring one of their tight ends in motion right. Again, it's Carr. Oh, that was dangerous. Throw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. One receiver to the left is Cooper. They'll come out in the pistol. Now Carr. Flushed out right. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. But they will not be able to capitalize as time has run out here on the first half of play. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They come out with one back and three tight ends.
All right, now, lucky 56. Gone.
And a big tight end shifting around. They'll throw on first down with Lynch. Caught left side by Hilton. And he's got some space here. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. T.Y. Hilton with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Broncos have taken the lead.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is the absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. Casey Hayward makes the tackle.
Really held him to a short gain on that one. And it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop the jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
They come out here in the eye. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he's going to lose yards. They take it.
Like, seriously, what the hell?
It's a loss of two, now third down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. Hey, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Throwing his car on third down. A bullet throw, but incomplete. Here's Marquette King now as he's on to punt for Oakland. This is taken at about the 14. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And the Broncos take over. First down and 10. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was really easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They come out here in the eye. They go again with Rawls. And some room to work. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected. But that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And he'll send the tight end in motion left. Now a toss. This is Rawls. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. Another pistol look here. Now they'll look to throw it with Lynch. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot, but they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. 5 wides in the game, 4 of them to the right side. Now Paxton Lynch on third and long. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Oh, man. For him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Now they try the right side here. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. It's the linebacker, Brandon Marshall, there on the tackle.
Okie dokie.
So 2nd and 9, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. One receiver to the left is Cooper. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Second down to the left side and complete for Amari Cooper. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
It's funny when I go back to our pregame meeting with Amari Cooper, and we mentioned, what if they play man coverage against you? He almost seemed offended by it, didn't he?
I'll beat it. That's basically what he said, right?
I mean, the best receivers we've ever talked to and covered, when you talk about covering them with one guy, they think that's a personal affront. If they feel like they can't just beat one defender, then they're not very good.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll take this one for about four up to the 40. Couple of Broncos there in on the tackle.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things, and they've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. One receiver to the left is Cooper. From the gun now on third down, Carr. And this is going to be incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Here's Marquette King now. He's been terrific so far. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners. And let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
Fucking ridiculous.
Leverage on this drive. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Well, if you do
really
coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Offense in a good spot here. Second and two. Looking to throw on second. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And the 45 at the 44. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it
impossible, it would seem.
Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? First down and 10 now for the offensive group. On first and 10, it's Lynch. They set up the screen to Rawls. And he is going to lose yardage here.
I can't read these plays any better.
It's a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I mean, my God.
You know the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
They give it to Roll. He'll be taken down just shy of midfield. He gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a third and five.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
Welcome back now to Denver. It's been a good one so far, just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. So third and five, third and medium here. Lynch to throw. Got a man. He finds Sanders. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Oh, my fucking God.
He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
He's brought down that time by a couple of Raiders. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
So they're operating in the red zone.
Here we go now.
They stay on the ground. Rawls again. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2.
Here we go now.
And they'll send the tight end in motion here. 3rd and 2, now Lynch. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. T.Y. Hilton, his 3rd touchdown of the season, all coming in this game. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some voice. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. But I think the Raiders are going to be able to hold on to it, yes. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was because that's all defenses talk about, getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right, a lost opportunity.
On 3rd and long, it's Carr surveying the field. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Gerald McCoy able to disrupt yet another pass play, his 3rd sack of the afternoon. Here's Marquette King now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. And Denver getting set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. Defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. It's an end around, Hilton. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Second down, here's Lynch. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish, because strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
Attempt carry for Thomas Rawls. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a 2 tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the 2 tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see 2 tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think of run. In this case,
oh my fucking god!
End zone for a Denver score. T.Y. Hilton from 4 yards out, and the Broncos will extend their lead. And let's count them up now. 1, 2, 3, 4 touchdown receptions for him in this game.
And just one shy of the NFL record. What a great performance. Going up and catching the football, creating space, and finding the end zone. That's what it's all about.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Here's Carr. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Call it a gain is 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. 13 yards there on the pickup, and it'll give the Raiders a first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
And it looks like this will be the last play before the 2-minute warning. All right, here we go. Carr now on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. Second down, here's Carr. Under pressure, they got him again. Von Miller in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. And the defense will try and pin their ears back and get pressure again here after the sack. It's third down. From the gun, it's Carr. He's got time in the pocket. And got his man complete. A heck of a play there on third down, but amazingly, they're still short for fourth. So with a yardage on that completion, he's now right at exactly 300 yards on the game.
And isn't that the magic number you get, all right? 300, that means it's going to go on a commemorative football to put on your mantle when they give you the game ball if your team wins. So much confidence flowing through him right now, throwing the football. I think it's permeated itself throughout the entire team. They feel good about what they're doing.
And the offense moving quickly to the line.
I remember in pregame when we were talking to him on the field, and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers. A few misshapen ones in there, and now we know why, trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart. Yeah, even for a talented receiver, those are tough to hang on to. First and 15 here behind the chains. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Carr to throw on second down. Can't find anyone open. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. They got to have six here. It's third and goal. Shotgun now for Carr. That's caught at the one. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Their big tight end. His first touchdown on the year. And the Raiders make some inroads here on that deficit. And now the Raiders will face an important two-point conversion attempt here. Carr will look to throw. And unable to connect, they don't get the two-point conversion here. A very pivotal two-point try that does not go their way. Now it's a big uphill battle for the rest of the fourth quarter.
The attempt was to try and make it a one-score game, right? Touchdown, get two, and now you've tied it up. Instead, they don't get it, still down 10.
Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. Two timeouts remaining defensively, but that shouldn't make much difference right here.
It really shouldn't, but a lot of coaches look at it similar to baseball with the intentional walk.
Always bringing in other
right? Sports.
Always,
hey, listen, think about the intentional walk, right? What if one gets past the catcher? What if he uncorks a wild one and now you still have an opportunity? That's why they like to use them all the way through.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal, that's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for Denver, they remain as hot as anyone, 6-0 now through the first month and a half. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Cincinnati Bengals. Meanwhile, for the Raiders, the losses are piling up as they drop to 1-5 now. And they'll get a home date next week against the Minnesota Vikings. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Broncos are winners as we say so long from Denver.